These casualties have just arrived in MSF's hospital in Hammam al-Ali, south of Mosul. The team in this specialized trauma unit treat patients wounded by bullets, bomb blasts or shrapnel. Most of the wounded are brought to the hospital having been stabilized in medical posts set up by the army near the front line. Opened 6 weeks ago, the hospital has already treated 1,400 patients, half of them women and children.
They usually come in big waves, so on the same day we can receive up to 50 injured, sometimes within 1 hour, and they all come together. They're family units that come together, not just single patients. So it's a really, really intensive project and intensive activity.
As the fighting intensified in February, MSF opened several facilities in the region. Teams are working in hospitals and maternity centers in and around Mosul and are providing primary health and mental health services in clinics set up in several displaced persons camps.
La situation elle est quand même assez urgente parce que si on voit l'opération à l'est de Mossoul, en 3 mois, on a eu environ 1300 blessés et environ 200 000 déplacés qui sont sortis de la ville de Mossoul Est. Là aujourd'hui à Mossoul Ouest, en 1 mois, on a les mêmes chiffres qu'en 3 mois à Mossoul Est.
The situation of the 400,000 people still in western Mosul is particularly alarming.
The areas we have visited in West Mosul, there are huge infrastructural damage. Most of the houses have been destroyed during the offensive, the military offensive. There are food needs, there are no water and sanitation system, as most of it has been destroyed during the war. There is an overall lack of supplies. There are no education system in place, no vaccination, no primary health care access, and no obstetric care.
The teams working in the hospital in Kayaha are seeing the consequences of the deterioration in living conditions in Mosul and the hardship in the displaced persons camps and their impact on children's health.
The children coming from Mosul, most of the parents was forced to give the children food that is not appropriate for the age, like yogurt or flour with water or sugar with water for children less than 6 months. They can have a war injury, bomb blasting or other kind of severe injury. It's frequent to find children with the bronchiolitis also in our countries, but here they are a lot because probably the virus are spread very easily in the tent as the tent are overcrowded and the children are very small.
For the hundreds and thousands of people who've been forced to flee, the harsh conditions in the camps only add to the psychological scars left by the war and the uncertainty about their return to a city largely reduced to rubble.